He changed physics. He gave gravity a reason to rethink itself. He turned space and time upside down. And he did all that without socks. Albert Einstein, the genius who knew the world is relative, but humor is absolute. He once said, "If you can't explain it simply, you don't understand it well enough." And honestly, that's exactly how TikTok feels today. Welcome to the story of a man who proved that genius and chaos aren't opposites. Often they have the same hairstyle. Childhood and Youth, The Little Rebel from Ulm. 1879, Ulm, Germany. A baby is born. One that will later prove that time is relative, especially in the mornings. His father, an electrical engineer. His mother, a pianist. A classic recipe for genius. Electricity meets melody. Albert spoke late. So late, his parents thought he wasn't fully receptive. Today, we'd just call him introverted with deep thoughts. Then he received a compass as a gift, and boom, he discovered invisible forces move things, and that magnets are cooler than homework. One of his teachers allegedly said, "He'll never amount to anything." Spoiler, he was wrong. Einstein later said, "Great spirits have always encountered violent opposition from mediocre minds." Mic drop, Mr. Teacher. Patent office and miracle year. Clerk by day, genius by night. After university, no job offers. So Einstein ended up at the patent office. His job? Reading ideas from others. His hobby? Reinventing the universe. By day, stamps. By night, space-time. He was like the Batman of physics, just with worse hair.
Huh?
1905, his miracle year. Four papers, one containing the world's most famous equation, E equals mc squared. Or, as Einstein himself put it, "If relativity turns out to be true, the Germans will call me a German, and the French a world citizen. If it turns out to be false, the French will call me a German, and the Germans a Jew." Ouch, but fair. But behind his blazing genius stood someone history almost forgot. Mileva Marić. A woman whose mind rivaled his, only she lived in a time when women hardly existed at universities. Born 1875 in Titel, then Austria-Hungary, today Serbia. From early on, she showed extraordinary mathematical talent, so much so that she was allowed as a girl to attend a boys' school in Ruma, almost revolutionary for the time. In 1896, she became one of the first women ever admitted to ETH Zurich, in the same class as Albert. Her grades in physics and mathematics, in several subjects, higher than his. In his letters, he wrote, "Our work will change the world." But the world wasn't ready for her work, wasn't ready for women. She lost her studies, her recognition, and in the end, him. Many historians suspect that some of his early ideas would never have existed without her. Maybe the universe was just when he later gave her his Nobel Prize money, a sum worth about $32,000 at the time, roughly 12 years of his salary, a silent apology from genius to genius. Relativity and fame, when time is a joke and serious too. Einstein said that time is relative. What does that mean? Very simply, if you talk with someone attractive for 2 hours, it goes by in 2 minutes. If you sit on a hot stove for 2 minutes, it feels like 2 hours. That is relativity. But then there's the famous twin paradox, the moment when even physicists say, "Okay, wow." Imagine two twins. One stays on Earth, the other flies through space at near light speed. For that one, time passes slower. When he returns, his brother is old, and he barely aged. That's not sci-fi, that's physics. Astronauts on the ISS today measure tiny differences in their time. They literally live milliseconds into the future. Einstein predicted all of this with a pen and an idea. The 1919 solar eclipse, proof painted on the sky. The eclipse confirmed the impossible. How, you ask? Very simply, Einstein predicted that even light, the fastest thing there is, would bend under gravity. The sun, with its enormous mass, curves the space around it, and so does the path of light. Let's take a closer look. Imagine a star positioned directly behind the sun. Normally, we wouldn't be able to see it at all, but the immense mass of the sun bends the space around it, and with it, the path of light. The light from that distant star is slightly deflected by the sun's gravity, redirected toward Earth. So when we look through a telescope, it appears as if the star is shining beside the sun, even though it's actually behind it. But you can only see that when the sun is blocked, so the British astronomer Arthur Eddington aimed his cameras at the sky, while millions on Earth had no idea they were witnessing a turning point in human history. Stars that should have been hidden behind the sun appeared slightly shifted, exactly as Einstein had predicted. One photo proved that space and time truly bend. A single snapshot, and the universe had a sense of humor. "Einstein's theory triumphs," screamed the headlines. Overnight, he became an icon, the first pop star of physics. And when shown the images, he simply said,
"Didn't I tell them?"
He had humor. When someone told him he was the smartest person in the world, he replied,
"Oh, come on, I know Marie Curie too."
And when asked about the book 100 Authors Against Einstein, he commented,
"If I were wrong, one would have been enough."
Flight and guilt, the conscience of a genius.
When the Nazis came to power, he fled Germany. They called his physics Jewish. He called nationalism the measles of humanity. Later, he co-signed a letter to President Roosevelt, written by fellow scientists, warning that Hitler might pursue nuclear weapons. He wanted to alert, not arm. But when Hiroshima fell, he was horrified. He fought until his death for disarmament and against stupidity, because, as he said,
"Two things are infinite, the universe and human stupidity. I'm not sure about the universe."
Hollywood and legacy, the genius who laughed. Einstein's theories live not only in labs, but in cinema. In Interstellar, astronauts travel through wormholes and black holes. Hours on a planet equal decades in space. Pure relativity. Physicists like Kip Thorne computed Gargantua using Einstein's equations so precisely that the simulation appeared in scientific journals. Einstein would have loved that. Finally, his theory got good CGI. He pursued a unified equation until the end. Space, time, energy, matter, and maybe what we call God. He never found it. But perhaps that was his final lesson. Not everything that's real can be measured. He said, "Imagination is more important than knowledge, for knowledge is limited." And that was his legacy, a mind that never stopped playing. Today, he's alive, in our theories, our GPS systems, and in every terrible physics joke on the internet. He hated socks, but he never lost his footing. Einstein, the genius with the tongue, the man who proved, if you want to understand the world, start with a smile.